On behalf of the Kennedy Center, it's a great pleasure to welcome you all to tonight's Millennium Stage performance, where every night of the year at 6 p.m. we present a free performance brought to you by Target and the Fannie Mae Foundation. And when you're not able to be here with us in person, we'd like to encourage you to visit us online at kennedy-center.org, where we broadcast each night's performance live over the web at 6 p.m. Eastern Time, as well as archiving the past performances, all of our past performances, so you can see what we've been doing all these years here in the Grand Foyer Millennium Stage. Now, tonight's performance is a part of this year's Smithsonian Folklife Festival, and it's been an exciting new partnership for us here at the Kennedy Center. The folks at the Folklife Festival have brought together some of the greatest musicians, as well as traditional artisans of all sorts, but some of the greatest musicians from Mali, from Appalachia, and from Scotland. And for any of you who've been here with us at the Millennium Stage for any of the shows over the past 2 weeks, we've had some incredible performances, and tonight will certainly be no exception. In fact, it will just drive the point home. I imagine a lot of you folks know the artists that we have with us here this evening. It's a thrill for me. I've been fans of all of them for a long time. Of course, Dougie MacLean, originally with the Tannehill Weavers as a fiddler, and has gone on to become the most recognized and celebrated songwriter in all of Scotland, and some of the greatest composers and players that have ever come out of that country were from the band Silly Wizard, and Phil and Johnny Cunningham have gone on to conquer all sorts of musical challenges, and we're just so glad to have them all here with us. So if you please join me in a warm Washington, D.C. welcome for our first artists up this evening, Phil and Johnny Cunningham.
Thank you very much. How are you all doing? You have to excuse the mess of me. We were playing in a field a moment ago, and I honestly thought that between playing in the field and coming to the Kennedy Center, there would be a hotel stop. But there wasn't, so anyway, it's nice to have mud on your feet in the Kennedy Center, isn't it?
Yes. We always knew that ultimately our careers would lead us to the lobby. And here we are.
So, and I've made my excuse for the way I am now. What have you got to say for yourself?
I just look like this all the time. I've looked like this since about 1964, and in fact,
Johnny came out like that, you know.
I came to America in these clothes. It's a very nostalgic thing. America's been very good to me, but not good enough to me. Allow me to afford new clothes.
Okay, well, we're going to... Johnny and I haven't played together since, 11 years was the thing. And yesterday was the first time for 11 years, so we're kind of...
See, everybody's applauding me having played together for 11 years.
Yeah.
Yes, let's have 11 years more of not hearing the two of them together. Thank you very much.
So we're going to play stuff that, well, the stuff that we've chosen to play is the stuff that we think we still know. And we were taking great comfort from all of that. And so we'll just fire off. The first tune is called Drummond Castle. It's about a castle in a place called Drummond. And yes,
this is a cultural event, you'll learn absolutely nothing.
Then there's the Jig of Slurs, the Athol Highlanders. That's Athol with a T-H, I said.
By the way, Athol. We've had
Athol
problems.
Yeah. And then a tune called The Apple Tree. And, the best of luck. That's all I can say.
Best of luck to you.
I always wondered why I cleared my throat before I played the accordion. As if it's going to make any difference. Excited.
Oh, I'm frightened.
Same thing. Different name. One, two.
You know, this is the same seat I sat in the last time I played here.
I don't want to ask how you know.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you. We're going to play a slow air now, because we have to. This is a tune I wrote years ago. I can't remember how long exactly, but it was...
It was in the late 40s. Easily in the last millennium, actually.
In the millennium. I wrote it for my mum and dad when they had their pearl anniversary, so that was a long, long time ago. In a stroke of genius, I called it The Pearl. So, I'm very clever, you know.
Right.
Look, we should wait, because Mum might be watching on the internet.
Hello, Mum.
Hello, Mother.
Hello.
She doesn't have a computer, but you know. It's always good to be safe.
Okay. The Poil.
Thank you very much. We're going to go on now with some waltzes. The first two I wrote after spending some time in Brittany and then in Paris. The first tune is called Leaving Brittany, which I wrote while I was leaving Brittany.
Good man.
And,
good lad.
And then the second waltz is called the Perno Waltz, which was written after leaving, or actually not leaving, Perno. And then there's a third waltz, but Phil didn't want to play it. But I would beseech you to please ask him to play this tune.
Oh, not a tune, there's no bother, no bother.
Thank you very much.
It's a tune called the Le Minuet, and that's French for the minuet, I believe.
Well, both Phil and I are bilingual, which is okay, I believe.
I learned Le Minuet from a great button accordion player from Galway called Martin O'Connor. His pet name is Fartin' Martin, because he's prone to on occasion. And one time we were in the car together and just outside Galway, myself and Martin O'Connor and Dolores Keane, a great singer. And we're driving along and we'd been for a curry the night before and things were kind of
boiling,
a bit delicate, and he let one slip, you see, and Dolores was in the car and he didn't want her to know that he'd done it, so he kind of muttered something, as you know, this car was just, it was dreadful and everybody's eyes were watering. And he said, "Jesus, Dolores," he said, "there's a terrible smell off of that silage." And Dolores says, "Did you eat much of it, Martin?"
So it's always great to bring culture to America. We are ambassadors for our nation. But you know, there's great truth. So, and if anyone would like to waltz, I'm sure you're...
Yes, it's a big room.
There's plenty of room.
I quite fancy waltzing myself.
There you go.
Okay, I might.
All right, fine.
Does that thing that's flying around, does it bite?
It will. You'll get
not now.
you'll get what they call the West Nile virus from that.
Thank you.
Just add to your list. It's great because in America, like, you can just get SARS, monkeypox, and West Nile virus just in an afternoon. It's the land of plenty. I love it. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot. Actually, we're very proud to be able to kind of show you before we do it here in DC, before we take it to Broadway. It's our new show entitled Liver Dance. But it's our great pleasure to introduce to you our special guest and a very, very old friend. We've known each other since we were fetuses.
It's feet high.
Oh, okay. Our great pal, fantastic singer-songwriter and a great guy, please welcome Mr. Dougie MacLean, my dancing partner.
Hello? I was clever, I put the white shirt in his guitar case, you see. it's a great privilege to be here, and I'll start off with this wee song of mine. It seems to me that the older I get, the more like my father I become, which is a bit terrifying, actually. And and I grew up in a very beautiful part of Perthshire, just outside the town of Dunkeld, and it's a wee lochs and things. It's a very, very beautiful place, but in my late teens, I couldn't wait to get away from the place, you know. And so I play the fiddle. Me and Johnny have played a lot of fiddle together over the years. And I joined this band called the Tannehill Weavers and ended up in an old beat-up white transit van with four bald tires and no starter motor and no insurance, as I remember, as well. Travelling up and down German autobahns and French autoroutes, trying to find myself, you know, as one does at that age. And I realise now that actually I could have saved myself a lot of stress and angst and bother, because actually there I was sitting at home back in Dunkeld, in the smoking the pipe, reading the newspaper in front of the fire, in the shape of my father. So a few well-chosen questions before I'd left would have kept me out of a lot of trouble and kind of made things a lot easier. Anyway, so I wrote this wee song about it, and I'll try and sing it now. Talking with my father, he's talking with his son, and I don't need to look any further for the one I have become. He said, listen to that curlew, oh, that's a sound I love to hear. Strange reflection that we look through, well, that finally finds us here. In this place where life's heart thunders, in this place where time holds still, in this place of harmony and wonder and values not of gold fulfilled. Walking with my father across these gentle Perthshire hills, it's timeless mysteries that we gather that make the memories that we fill. He says, don't fix what is not broken, no need to find what's not been lost, for it's a heavy gate we have to open, an endless field we have to cross. In this place where life's heart thunders, in this place where time holds still, in this place of harmony and wonder and values not of gold fulfilled.
There will always be the brave one, be the one who turns away. All too many things left undone, oh, and so much left to say. I'm talking with my father, he's talking with his son, and I don't need to look any further for the one I have become. In this place where life's heart thunders, in this place where time holds still, in this place of harmony and wonder and values not of gold fulfilled.
Try that.
In this place where life's heart thunders, in this place where time holds still, in this place of harmony and wonder and values not of gold fulfilled.
One of the great things about an event like this, you know, when you're all sitting out there and the festival that we've just come from, is if you kind of get involved with what we are doing. And the musical culture that I come from, is music wasn't a passive thing where you just kind of all sat there and kind of appreciated. You know, kind of. All the songs had wee refrains and that built into them so that the company could join in. And this wee song of mine's got a very easy chorus. And it seems to me that, you know, as you're going through life, if you're allowed to make mistakes, you know. You're allowed to be like fall down and make mistakes. The one thing you must not do is kind of lie down and kind of give up. And you know, but at least if you're out there making mistakes, it means you're kind of tackling the whole kind of business sort of head on, you know. And this wee song's about that. And the chorus is easy. You sing, you can fall, but you must not lie down. You can fall, but you must not lie down. And then there's a wee complicated bit, which is, I know you're lost in the deep of the fiddle's sweet sound. You can fall, but you must not lie down. And one of the other great things about coming to a festival like this is that you actually get a chance to meet old friends. So I'd like to welcome Johnny and Phil back out onto the stage with me, because they're going to play along with this new song. And I think that line, I know you're lost in the deep of the fiddle's sweet sounds, really good for
some. Yes, I have been lost for a long time.
So there's a lot of you in here, so it would be nice to try and make a wee bit of noise with this, OK? And,
are there lights flashing or am I having a stroke again? The lights did change, right?
No.
Speak your mind, she said, but there are words best left alone. Try to be kind, she said, for there's no grace in doing wrong. When you're standing on your highest hill, and you shout but no one hears, you can fall, but you must not lie down. You can fall, but you must not lie down. I know you're lost in the deep of the fatal sweet sound. Oh, you can fall, but you must not lie down.
That's what you're saying. We'll try that again, huh?
You can fall, but you must not lie down. You can fall, but you must not lie down. I know you're lost in the deep of the fatal sweet sound. You can fall, but you must not. Tired wings. Oh, there's no need to know it all. Listen how the silence sings. Now is the time for standing tall. And when you're standing on your highest hill, and you shout, but no one hears, make a bit of noise. You can fall, but you must not lie down. You can fall, but you must not lie down. I know you're lost in the deep of the fatal sweet sound. Oh, you can fall, but you must not lie down. Scatter diamonds everywhere. And when you're standing on your highest hill, you shout, but no one hears. You can fall, but you must not lie. You can fall, but you must not lie down.
You a bit louder?
I know you're lost in the deep of the fatal sweet sound. Oh, you can fall, but you must not lie down.
So you sing it on your own? Try it.
You can fall. There's no grace in doing wrong. you're standing on your highest hill. And you shout, but no one hears. Last time, you can fall, but you must not lie down. You can fall, but you must not. Oh, you can fall, you must not lie down.
Big hand for
Dougie. Thank you very much.
Dougie MacLean. He's going to be back to finish off with us in a couple. Brilliant. That's great. This is just like old times, except none of us have any energy now.
You know, we were actually all in the same band at one point. Well, Johnny left Silly Wizard. Dougie joined.
I left Silly Wizard to form a duo with Dougie. And neither one of us had any money. And I got a phone call from Dougie the next day. And Dougie said, well, since you've left, the boys want me to join. So it's nice to be playing back with Dougie again after all these years.
I don't know what we're playing because he didn't say, and because I'm the younger brother, I have to do as I'm told. So I'm going to ask.
What are we playing? Oh, the Hut and Staff and Island. Set.
Oh no, no,
we'll do it. Sailor Song and Sailor Song. Do like set.
Right. Okay.
Why don't you do it on day? Oh, great. Okay. I'll tell you exactly you what you're doing. I'll talk amongst myself. But 15 minutes. So do the Sailor's air, that lovely air, and then we'll play the. Thank you very much.
There's flies on them and stuff.
This is just terrible. I don't know. It's all come to me.
I feel like Charlie Brown.
Pig pen. Yeah, play an air, then we'll do the long set, and then we'll get Dougie back up, and then that'll, you know.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's great, you know. Hope we're not too slick for you. We're taking this show to Vegas and just leaving it there.
I live in a place called Aegis, A-I-G-A-S. It's called the Krask of Aegis. And someone from America sent me a letter that was addressed to the Krask of Vegas. I also got one addressed to the Krask of Angus, which I thought was quite interesting. It means the place before, the place beyond. Now, how Celtic can you get? It's a gate. You know? That's what the Celtic term for a gate is. The place before, the place beyond. This is a request, and I don't normally do requests unless I'm asked, so it's a... This is a tune that I composed one night. I was at a charity auction, a charity dinner. And I'd gone along with 2 CDs and a tune book to hand out for the, you know, for the
That's
charity.
That's compact discs, by the way.
I know, it's been 11 years and I'm remembering why.
I was just trying to...
I took along a couple of CDs and a tune book and I was going to hand that over to the, you know, for the charity, and I realised that everybody else was handing over hundreds and thousands of pounds to the charity, and my 2 CDs and my tune book were very Scottish looking. The contribution was definitely of a Scottish nature. So during the dinner, I wrote this tune on the back of a napkin. And then I auctioned the right to name it. And a nice man paid a lot of money for it, and he called it Sarah's Song for his wife, Mary. And then we're going to play a whole bunch of other stuff after that. Okay. Something's wrong with my instrument, if you pardon me. Okay. Ready, steady, go.
Thank you. Thank you. Thanks. We'd like to... thanks a lot.
Thank you very much.
Thanks.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Well, we'd like to finish up for you with the three of us up, and hopefully you'll sing along with this great song. So please welcome back to the stage Mr. Dougie MacLean.
Oh, all right, big man.
How's it doing, big man? All right. Good to see you, man.
Yeah, I've got a wee song, which it's a very old song of mine, and it's now become kind of part of common culture at home. And I wrote it about 20 years ago, and actually was busking in France. And but the song's become part of the culture, and you know, if you hear people, it's played at football matches and rugby matches. It's played by pipe bands at the military tattoo, and if you see bunches of drunk Scotsmen on holiday in Spain in the tavernas late at night, they'll probably be singing this wee song. And it's a lovely thing as a songwriter to get a song that becomes like that. And I was telling Johnny and Phil earlier on a great story that some friends were telling me about the... you know, it's become part of common culture when you hear these wee stories, because a friend of mine, I was watching this old couple getting thrown out of the bar, a bar in Glasgow, one rainy night, you know, and the two of them were quite sort of steaming, you know, and the old lady, she's hitting the old boy over the head with the handbag, and they're having this terrible argument outside the pub, and she's just getting kind of a little raucous, and it's kind of a drizzly night, and the argument gets very, very big, and there's a wee line in the song, which the chorus, for those of you who don't know it, the song has a line which goes, "Let me tell you that I love you and I think about you all the time." And let me tell you that I love you and I think about you all the time. Anyway, this wee rockers outside the bar got to a kind of climax, and she stormed off away up into the street, into the mist, into the dark of the night, you know. And my friend was watching this, and he saw the old boy, and he was staggering just now. For a few seconds he stopped, and then he started sort of running after her into the mist with his arms in the air, going, "Let me tell you that I love you." And I hope it worked for him, you know. I mean, it's one of those things, you know. But anyway, this wee song's been very dear to me. Okay. I don't know if you can see the changes that have come over me in these last few days. I've been afraid that I might drift away. So I've been telling old stories, singing songs that make me think about where I came from. That's the seasons why I seem so far away today. Oh, let me tell you that I love you, but I think about you all the time. Caledonia, you're calling me. Now I'm going home. If I should become a stranger, you know that it would make me more than sad. Caledonia's been everything I've ever had. Oh, and I have moved and I've kept on moving. Proved the points that I needed proving. Lost the friends that I needed losing, found others on the way. Oh, and I have tried and I've kept on trying. I've stolen dreams, yes, there's no denying. I have traveled hard with conscience flying somewhere with the wind. You can sing this as well. Oh, and let me tell you that I love you, that I think about you all the time. Caledonia, you're calling me, and now I'm going home. For if I should become a stranger, you know that it would make me more than sad. Caledonia's been everything I've ever
I'm sitting here before the fire, the empty room, the forest choir, the flames that couldn't get any higher. Well, they've weathered now, they've gone. But I'm steady thinking, my way is clear, and I know what I will do tomorrow. When the hands have shaken and the kisses flowed, well, I will disappear. Oh, and let me tell you that I love you, that I think about you all the time. Caledonia, you're calling me, and now I'm going home. But if I should become a stranger, you know that it would make me more than sad. Caledonia's been everything I've ever...
Again, and I'll just shift this mic. Oh, and let me tell you that I love you, that I think about you all the time. Caledonia. Oh. And, if I should become a stranger, you know that you
have you do the last chorus on your own, because Dougie supply of Viagra ran out. Let me tell you, but I love you, come on.
Oh, and let me tell you that I love you, and I think
very happy that you've asked us to come back to play another one, because the dressing room is miles away.
What kind of tuning is this thing?
Dougie MacLean and my wee brother.
Thank you. And we'll hopefully see you next time.